Prevention is better than cure. And if my late wife had the opportunity of early detection, if the doctors at home in Nigeria were a little more careful, it is highly probable that my wife would be here today. We cannot bring her back, but we can ensure that others do not suffer the same fate, that others take advantage of this campaign to raise awareness so that every woman can, from time to time, even when you feel you are hurting, you feel nothing is wrong with you, there is no harm in going to reconfirm. After you reconfirm, there is no harm every 6 months to go and reconfirm. Because somebody doesn't have malaria in the morning, they begin to have malaria in the evening. So the operative word is constant checking. Like the wife of the deputy governor said, it has been very well established by medical practitioners that cancer is terminatable. It can be terminated if it is discovered before it spread. And the only way to bring that about is through regular checks. I think the executive director reminds us in her remarks that it is not only breast cancer, there are several other forms of cancer, including one that afflicts a lot of men. Again, like breast cancer, early detection can make a lot of difference. So I think for all of us, in government, out of government, we have responsibility to contribute to this campaign. We encourage our people to realize that we all can benefit. Cancer does not respect any office. It doesn't respect governor. As you have seen, it doesn't respect the first lady. If it did, my wife would be here. So, the only option we have is for us to continue to carry out checks from time to time and to enlighten others. We are hopeful that very soon the hospital that is under construction will be completed. And we'll be able to set up a cancer unit where all the necessary gadgets and machines and equipment required for early detection and treatment are available. So that we do not have to travel far to be able to have access to these facilities. But let me say that it is not only cancer that endangers our life. The fact that some of us, we eat so much, or even when we don't eat too much, we eat the wrong food, sometimes at the wrong time. From our homes, we jump into a car, air condition. From the air condition car, we jump into our air condition office. At the end of the working day, we jump out from the air condition office to the air condition car, to our air condition parlor, to our air condition bedroom. So we do not do any form of exercise. Again, medical experts have established the fact that your health status is what you eat, or what you fail to eat, how much you eat, plus or minus exercise, equals your health. So I think, therefore, that we should all internalize the idea of coming out from time to time to do exercise. As we walk around the streets, and I saw a very senior military officer, an air commodore, a colonel in the army, several other military officers, the commissioner of police, all of us walking by the streets, like very ordinary people, you could see the excitement in the face of our people. If you have to remind them that to walk is not a symbol of poverty. But too many of us think that by walking is because you have no money to enter the tool. I'm hoping that maybe from now onward, once a week or twice a week, once a month or twice a month, we organize health walk and encourage all civil servants to take part in it and encourage our people, whether they are in government or not in government, civil servants or not civil servants, so that we all internalize the whole idea of exercise. I don't know if you noticed what I noticed today. There are young people here, much, much younger than me, but they were breathing as if they fell from Inu cooking. Because this is probably the first time they are walking on the street. People like us who are always carrying placards protesting over all sorts of things, we are used to this. And I saw one capitalist here. He was sweating like he could. Who is approaching Christmas season because he's afraid. And I am not going to say anything at all, but he didn't did very well. She was truly a woman in there, you know, on the street. You know, somebody told me, if you have no money and you have ideas, you can still survive. So, before that is that Nobina and I will walk all the way to this place. Some people could not get here, but she told her. Is that a woman that? She was the first to arrive this place. That is not her. So the man mistress, you know, she just flew across and then resumed at Bishop Road. And then she was here. Another round of applause for her. So I want to thank all of you for being part of this. In particular, I want to really appreciate the senior military officers here. There's always been my wish that when you have this, I don't know, the technical word, when you have this military training that I like to join. An air commodore. This time he wasn't airborne, he was right on the ground. And the colonel was with us. And I saw two soldiers giving us that assurance that we are safe. So for me, I think it's something we should generalize. I want to thank all of you so much. I don't know what the organizers have put in place because we burn a lot of some liters of water. We ought to be able to replenish. I didn't look as if there is a breakfast table around. I thought after I had this walk, we are entitled to something. Or if there is nothing, well, chicken is part of the head strategy. There is something. Where?
Here.
Outside?
No, here.
All right. If you like. like it and we're all preparing. If it's not too good, then you won't. So once again, good morning and thank you for being part of this.